I tend to think of Cupertino High School as kind of a vast education machine.
So this is not just a Mickey Mouse operation.
There's no other place like it.
I think Cupertino High School is a school with a lot of spirit, a lot of variety of people, and a place where there's a real I care about you attitude.
Good morning.
Chunky monkey.
As long as you can see my gorgeous face.
How would you describe Cupertino to me?
I'd describe it as a big gray building with classrooms, with teachers that teach you things.
A lot of friendly people in it. And
confusing. It's like so big, you know, if you don't know where you're going, you don't know how to get there. Does that make sense?
It's really easy to find friends at this school because there are a lot of nice people.
Well, I would describe it as a really spirited place, and people are really close here, and I think it's pretty much really easy to make friends. I mean, pretty much everyone's really friendly, and will you stop nodding yet?
Above all, I think I would say this is a happy place. Staff and students are happy to be here.
Dominating, because I can't see anybody stopping us.
Thank you.
to get the Pratt Spirited to help our team. And so just a lot of crowd participation and support, definitely, for our team, for our guys out there. They're working really hard.
Okay, and what is the importance of crowd spirit in determining the outcome of the game?
It's very important because it really pumps up the players and encourages them and supports them and shows them that we're 100% behind them. Yeah, it just hopefully psychs them up and it just shows them our support for them.
Thank you. every now and then. And now we're back where we started. Here we go round again.
Talking and they're saying that you're leaving. So unhappy with the way that
you've been living.
Some people that like to have a chance to sit down and read.
What made you choose German over any other foreign language?
Well, German's in my background, and I hope to go back there someday and find out about my roots and where my whole family came from.
We always wish for money. We always wish for fame. We think we have the answer.
Thank you. cool, though. We've got those valedictorians, and we've got the honor people. Now, this next row is the one you want to start filling. Five cups of each on each side.
I am convinced that the Cupertino Class of 91 is one of the best classes ever. Through many adversities, this class has proven it has everything needed to measure up to greatness.
Most of us have chosen the paths we wish to travel. And as we each are different, so are our goals. The Cupertino Class of 1991 will yield doctors, lawyers, teachers, and perhaps even an Olympic wrestler.
As a group, our togetherness and like of one another vastly outweigh the turmoil and hatred. A great poet once stated, "Life is very long when you're lonely." Our time in high school was very short. Thank you.
People favor underdogs, but follow only top dogs. Fight for underdogs anyway. What you spend years building may be destroyed overnight. Build anyway. People really need help, but may attack you if you help them. Help people anyway. Give the world the best you've got, and you'll get kicked in the teeth. Give the world the best you've got anyway.
Please join me now in thanking and honoring Susan Jensen, recipient of the Principal's Award.
These students have satisfactorily met all the requirements of the state of California and the school district, and the Board of Education congratulates them and wishes them great well wishes for the future. And it is my pleasure on behalf of the entire board to confer these diplomas on Cupertino High School's class of 1991.
We, the class of 1991, would like to thank each and every one of you who have touched our lives. Thank you so very much.
August 2nd, 1990, 100,000 Iraqi troops stormed across the border and brutally captured its tiny neighbor of Kuwait in a matter of hours. President Bush responded by sending 125,000 troops to protect Saudi Arabia in Operation Desert Shield.
Saddam is making the mistake of his life
The United Nations issued a January 15th deadline for Iraq to withdraw from Kuwait. More than a million armed personnel stared each other down, waiting.
The liberation of Kuwait has begun.
5 months ago, Saddam Hussein started this cruel war against Kuwait. Tonight, the battle has been joined.
For 5 weeks, the coalition battered Baghdad and Kuwait with air attacks. Iraq was so overwhelmed with the strength of the Allies that its only response was through Soviet-made Scud missiles. American-made Patriot missiles intercepted most of the incoming Scuds. Hussein attempted to dislodge other Arab states from the coalition by attacking Israel. The Jewish nation refused to retaliate against fatal bombings of Tel Aviv, and the coalition remained intact. In a desperate act of environmental blackmail, Hussein ordered the release of millions of barrels of oil into the Persian Gulf and the torching of hundreds of Kuwaiti oil wells. Back home, there was no shortage of opinions on either side of the Gulf War issue.
You want me to go there? Why you want me to go Kuwait?
On February 23rd, the multinational force led by General Norman Schwarzkopf launched the much-anticipated ground offensive against the Iraqis. With Iraqi soldiers surrendering by the thousands, the war lasted little more than 100 hours. Saddam Hussein accepted all UN resolutions calling for his withdrawal from Kuwait and payment of reparations and war damages. As school ended, the war's effects lingered. Millions of Kurdish refugees who sought safety in the mountains waited, both hungry and cold, for a chance to return home.
With all his heart.